Hello YouTube viewers, welcome to my show Computer Wednesday. In today's episode we're going to take a look at a bit kind of obscure topic, optical disc. So let's dive right into it. So first we have to understand what it is. It's a very simple idea. The idea is you store your data rather than on magnetic tape as we used to do in compact cassette days. We're going to store it on a disc. Now we stored it there. It's more or less same as what you have for a floppy drive. However, the difference is that we're going to read and write on it using laser. Now, this is the crucial aspect. This means there is no physical contact, as in nothing is touching it. That's why it can last for much, much, much longer. And there are many standards of basically lasers that were used. Based on those lasers, we got better and better data density. These are the three standard you must be very familiar with. First is compact disc, then you have DVD, then you have Blu-ray. And as you can see, one was introduced in 1982, had barely 700 MB. That time it was phenomenal. That time, that means it like it could have upwards of 80 to 90 floppy drive. And then we jumped to DVD, which went upwards of in capacity in 4.7 gigabyte single layer, and it was from 1995. And then we come to Blu-ray. This was single layer capacity of 25 GB, and not to mention it was introduced in 2006. So suffice to say, this technology has been there for quite a long time. As in DVD, you can still buy. CD is kind of difficult to find nowadays, but DVD is still going strong. And all these three have similar structure. That's why they all look the same size. They even have the same principle of operation. However, the only thing that changed is the laser. Now, as you can see, this is what we call CD laser. It's basically red. So the wavelength, it's kind of very big. Now, big wavelength, it means you are gonna have the on-off signal. You must know that binary is on-off signal. So how we store that on-off signal, it's using pits and pots. Basically, if you have a dot, that's on. If you have a valley, it's off. Basically, that's how it's stored, on, off, on, off. Binary data is stored like this. And using this, because the beam itself, infrared light itself is so big, the spots was very big. That's why we can only put 700 MB. Then we shifted to basically more high quality laser, red, in red spectrum instead of infrared. Output, we got DVD. Then we moved further, that was blue, using blue laser, and we call it HD DVD, but it didn't catch on. Then somebody pushed it further, mainly Sony, and then they created what we call Blu-ray, which is very popular today. And Blu-ray, the pits and ports on them is very, very small, as in 330 nanometers. So it's kind of very, very small. You can't use your naked eye to see it. Barely you can see CDs in a microscope. You need electron microscope to see something like that. So this is what it is. No physical contact, using laser to read and write data. So why it is so popular? First, it's super cheap. Like, try to buy a 25 gigabyte, you know, USB, it's expensive. Now, you might say, okay, the price has been coming down. Yes, but to this day, if you want to buy a bulk storage, as in like, let's say you are a recording studio, you have to buy like, you know, millions of discs, and then you're gonna ship it out to your customer. You can't do that on pen drive. Like now, and whole reason Microsoft and Bill Gates even became as rich as they did is because of disk. Because without it, Microsoft would have been stuck in a position where they could not have shipped their OS to anyone else. They're like, yeah, we don't make the hardware. And let's say manufacturer like IBM, they could have like got some way to store the data. But how will Microsoft sell their data to open public? Introducing DVD. DVD is like a very, very good gift to the whole IT industry. The software industry literally took off because of this. There was a way now to sell software. You might say, okay, we used to do that with a floppy drive, but not to mention floppy drives had very serious risk of failing. And on top of that, they did not carry enough data. CDs started to sell a lot of software, then DVDs were really big for that. And not to mention, it's digital, it's fully digital. No, that means you can copy one disc millions of times without getting any errors. That is crucial for anything like large scale mass production. So this is awesome. And why all the companies love it, as in like the studios, Sony, Warner Brothers, they love it simply because they can do what's called copyright protection. So basically, even if you have the disc, you can't copy it. Like, I can barely play a proper DVD in my computer, but I and cannot copy the data from it. Why? Because it has copyright protection. So super cheap, high data density, and the fact that it's digital allows and also allows for copyright protection. That's why all your console games are still coming on disc. Now, then why it's becoming obsolete? If it's this awesome, then why it's becoming obsolete? First, the adoption rate from CD to DVD was kind of smooth. People were like, okay, we have something better now. That was a very smooth transition. Of course, it was expensive, but it was acceptable, and it gave enough of a, you know, boost in quality that people are like, you know, this is a worthwhile investment. However, when Blu-ray came along, the players, as in on which you're gonna play the disc, they were idiotically expensive, as in $300 to $800 to $1,000 at the time of launch. And that is, I already mentioned, 2007 year price, as in it was more expensive than a computer. So that's why the player cost, idiotically high player cost, acted as a absolute barrier. And jumping from CD to DVD is a clear night and day difference. Jumping from DVD to Blu-ray, it's not as clear as that. Why? Because many of you remember who are used to buying movies in CDs, is that they used, movie used to come in two CDs. DVD makes those two into one. So that's a, you will instantly know the difference. Oh, now I have only one DVD. So that's awesome. However, you still get one DVD with, you know, one disc with Blu-ray also. And the quality increase that they were giving, that HD high quality, requires you to have full HD LED TV or AMOLED TV or even a very high quality LCD TV projector or something like that, which not everybody had. So the jump in quality was not there to justify the fact. Like, if Blu-rays were coming out in the fact, like, let's say 10 movie in one disc, then it would have been different, but they were releasing higher quality movie. For that reason, the player cost was like kind of very hard to sell. On top of that, the titles they were releasing was idiotically high. They were not twice as expensive as DVD. Sometimes they were costing 10 times more than. And that's the point where it really died, because people may collect the money, save money, and then buy a player. If the movies that they're gonna buy on it is 10 to 20 times more expensive, then it's like, no. Only now the Blu-ray price is reaching a point where you can say, okay, a DVD is 1,000 rupees, and the Blu-ray would be like 4,000 to 5,000 rupees. So it's like at least in few X rather than 10-20X. For that reason, this really, really suffered. On top of that, this idea that DVD also struggled, but a very little amount, is because of that CRP, copyright protection. They put so much copyright protection, as in the standard they come up with at the beginning of Blu-ray, they changed mid-life, as in Blu-ray is still not dead, so it's unwise to say mid-life, but they changed it, meaning you could have old Blu-ray player which will not play new Blu-ray title even in the same format, as in not, I'm not saying like going from single layer to dual layer, because the copyright protection change, your old Blu-ray player will not work it. Now you're like, I bought this, now you can't use it. Too much, like, as in the copyright protection, they went crazy with this. They really, first Sony sold them the idea that this is uncrackable. I think that's why people kind of panicked. Like, everybody should have known, like, it's gonna be cracked sooner or later. At least make the customer who is gonna pay for it be happy that they are buying something. Rather than that, it became misery. Like, you could have a scenario where you could have a player and it's like, boom, in 3 years it's pointless, not because it's broken, simply because it will not play newer DVDs or Blu-rays. And there were a lot of different standards. These were the three: region lock, they still did it, DVD also suffered from this, and Blu-ray also, they did not learn from it. However, to their credit, the newer standard that has 100 GB capacity has no region lock. Let's hope so. And internet, this came at 2007. So in 2010, there was no internet that could even come close to competing with a Blu-ray in terms of quality. But because at that time cost was so high, at that time you could have had a scenario where you had a player but you could not play the new disc. You're getting it, like, they frustrated people. So at that time, at the launch of Blu-ray, the best player you could have bought was PlayStation 3, simply because it's a full-fledged computer and Sony keeps updating it rather than every single player they have on the market. If you could have bought this at the beginning of the time, it would have been cheaper than dedicated Blu-ray players, and not to mention it would have worked for much longer. And as of now, if you want to go into 4K Blu-ray territory, flat out don't, I would not even suggest you to buy any player, rather it be Samsung, rather it be from Sony. Don't even dare to do that. Just buy Xbox One S. Simply because this is a full computer, and if the standard change, they will make sure that it works with this. And this is cheaper. Flat out, this is cheaper. So just buy that and be happy. You will have one extra console, some free games and all things like that, but just buy that. So these things what really hurted it. People say internet did hurt it, but it was the final nail in the coffin. Internet did not just came out of nowhere in one day and killed it. It was just that too much copyright protection, too much different standards, and the fact that you had to buy game consoles to make sure that your disc will play kind of makes it very difficult. Then why should you care? Why I am making this video? First, this is still to this day best quality home media that you can get. Now you might say, okay, Netflix gives us 4K and Netflix gives us this and that. Here's the deal. They are cutting a lot of data on the audio system. While it is better, it is fundamentally much better than it used to be. However, you are still struggling in audio department. Especially if you have a home theater system, you can tell the difference on a blind test whether it's a Netflix and or a Blu-ray. The sound is the one that's getting compromised. And not to mention, even if you compare highest quality Netflix or highest quality streaming service with highest quality Blu-ray that is available, like let's say you want to watch Infinity War in all its glory, like you want to buy a 4K Blu-ray DVD with it, Blu-ray disc with it, there is no comparison. Like flat out, there is no comparison. And not to mention, you always need to be on net. Like if you want to use Netflix or things like that, this you don't. Like you may need to update the firmware once in a while. That's acceptable compared to Netflix where you have to be 24/7 online. I mean, like while you are watching the movie, that is. And not to mention, let's say you are in a home, you will slow down internet for everyone else who is using the internet. For that reason, still to this day, if you want to just chillax and watch an epic movie with epic quality, Blu-ray still provides the best path. And that is not the reason why I'm making this. This is the perfect backup medium that we have so far. Now, this makes a perfect archival backup. Now, the difference between backup and archival backup is that archival backup, you forget about it. Like you make that backup and you forget about it. You only go back to that when you need to. Like, let's say you forgot something, you made backup of in 5-6 years, and then you realized while typing on a computer, hey, I'm missing a file from this point. Then you go to your archival. The backup that you create in a hard drive is not meant to last. All it is like, okay, right now I'm working on it, right now it's there. Like, let's say your photographs, as your time will pass, your hard drive will die. You will misplace the photos. You will flat out delete photos without knowing it. And hard drives fail, they die over time. Like, they die very early, as in like if you are a heavy user, 3 year, yeah, hard drives are dead. 5 years max, they're dead. CDs, I have CDs which are like 10 to 15 years old and they still work. So they make very, very good, cheap archival storage. Where you, let's say I suffered very severely because of this. When I had photographs, I did not burn them to discs and then just, mailed it to my home or mailed it to my other relatives. So I have physical, different physical backups. And now, because hard drive failure happened, because of my SD card got corrupted, not corrupted as in like I accidentally formatted it, then I realized I had 2-3 days of photos in it that I have not backed up, then I lost it. But this way, you can store it and you can do it on cheap. And not to mention, many network attached storage comes with a disk drive, so you can back up data on that directly. Like you can have high priority data, like let's say photographs, family photographs that you want to make sure you don't lose, you can keep on these. And these are very cheap. So DVD, as I talk to you, makes perfect backup. And you might be like, okay, but it's only for 10-20 years. You can extend them by buying what's called archivable disk, because the disks, it itself inherently has no flaw. However, it is very susceptible to humidity. And the dye that was used on which you are doing the laser engraving, by which you are getting the data, that dye is very weak on the consumer grade. So if you buy the archivable grade, they have much stronger dye, so it takes longer to write on them. However, it will last longer, generally 50 years. So for that reason, you can be far more comfortable to buy those and put very important files on them. Heck, even use this normal, it will work for 10-20 years. I have already tested to 15 years time period, so I know what I'm talking about here. And you can easily seal this up in a vacuum, basically just have a Ziploc bag and run a vacuum. The reason is, if you can make sure this does not get does not come into contact with humidity, this is gonna last forever. And you might be like, what if players are no longer manufactured? Just buy one backup player and keep it. Like, just next to it, just keep buy one player and keep it. And not to mention, because to this day, you can still buy a player that can run CD. To this day, you can buy a player that can run DVD. To this day, you can buy a player that runs Blu-ray. Because they are doing backwards compatible, and not to mention audio CDs are still going, they're not no longer as popular as they used to, but they are still going strong. So for this reason, you always gonna have it. So that's why I wanted to make this video. It's like, if you have a photography hobby as I do, I have lost enough files, and I'm waiting to just now to upgrade to a Blu-ray and then directly start doing my DVD backup again. So I thought this is a very good information to share. So this was my presentation. I hope you guys liked it or learned from it. In that case, please leave a like. If you didn't, dislike it. And I would suggest you leave a comment what you want to see in the next episode of Computer Wednesday. And as always, subscribe, press the bell icon if you are free. And as always, thanks for watching.